and welcome to GB Gaming. We're doing another video. This time is a board game from the Mug and Meeple. I have the owner Glenn here. Say hello, Glenn, to YouTube.
Hello, YouTube.
And I have the lovely girl sitting with me as well.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be a confusing and scary night for us all.
We have Budweiser because we're cheap. You have wine though.
I've got wine.
You're sophisticated.
I'm doing the sophisticated thing.
So you're probably going
to
win.
At this point, this is not endorsed by the people.
Yes, this was not bought here. This was bought by us. The Mug and Meeple does not sell our press. Okay, now we've got the legal bits out of the way.
Right.
We're playing a game.
Yes, and we are playing Quartermaster General. For those people who want to look it up, go and have a look at Board Game Geek, where you'll find the description of this. So I guess you guys want to know how to play it, didn't you?
I do.
That would help. Yeah.
Well, the rule is Glenn gets to win. That's the rule. But I actually tell you what to say.
I like it.
So essentially, this is a game of supply and trying to win World War II. Two of us are going to play the Axis, and one of us is playing the Allies. Now, you're going to play the Allies.
I am rather quizzically playing the Allies. I've got, on my team, I've got the United Kingdom, the United States, and the Soviet Union. So I feel like I'm in the driving seat here. I feel like things are going well. However, who do you have?
Keith, are we the bad guys?
We are.
We're the bad guys.
I'm playing Axis with Ben, and I'm playing as the Germans. I'm Germany, and the Italians. How do you say Italian?
I'm Italian.
Hey, Italian. Hello, bellissimo. I'm doing the Italians, and then Glenn, you've got.
I've got Japan. I'm not doing the accent. I'm going to wreck it, so I'm not doing it.
So bad.
Terrible.
It's very honourable. It's the honourable. Are they honourable? Is that honourable?
That wasn't particularly honourable. We may be doing that again this game.
Well, if we offend anyone with a terrible accent, it's YouTube. Okay.
Okay, well, fine. Yeah. Right, so now you need to know how to play, right?
Right, yeah, yeah.
Okay, well, do you want to go ahead and shuffle your deck? And I will.
I've got three decks, I can't.
Yeah, you need to get shuffling, come on. Oh, so, essentially, we're going to play 20 turns, okay? We are going to go in order of. In this order, so it goes. I think this is right. Germany, United Kingdom, Japan,
right.
Soviet Union, Italy, and then United States. And that makes up one turn, and we're going to do that 20 times. So, who's United States? You're United States. So, every time you've taken your go as United States, just move the track marker on one, and we get to 20, the game ends. The game also ends if one of the players has 30 more victory points than the other player. And it also ends if two of the other person's supply captains fall to the enemy. So, okay. For example, if Germany and Italy fall to the Allies, then the Allies will win.
That's my intent.
All right.
You're going to get crushed.
Okay.
Look at you. You're surrounded on all sides.
So one of the keys to the game is that you'll see that the deck's all different sizes. Germany has 40 cards. United Kingdom has 39. Japan has 33. Soviet Union 34. Italy 30. Not very many at all. And United States 40 cards. And you're going to play one card per turn. So essentially, through the course of the game, you're at least going to play 20 cards. You're going to waste 3 cards at the beginning of the game, so that's already 3 down. And also, you might be forced to discard cards. Now, if you run out of cards, you're done. Like, you just play with what you've got in your hand, you play with what you can deck. If you run out of cards, you are done. If you are
feeling good about it,
if you are asked to discard cards and you don't have any, then effectively you are going to lose points. So you really don't want to run out of cards, so just be very, very careful. Okay, so the turn goes like this. You have some cards in hand. You will play a card, that's the first thing you do, and you literally just read the card, follow instructions. Then you have your supply step. This is when you work out whether your troops are in supply. And I'll go over these in more detail in a second. Then you have collect victory points. Now this is very important. Okay, don't forget to collect your victory points. I think the house rule for tonight is if you forget your victory points, you don't get them. Like normally in the Mug and Meeple, we're kind of caring. We're kind of caring and we help people, but with these two losers, no. It's gonna be cutthroat this evening. You forget your points, you lose your points.
The grudge is on. The Axis are winning.
Right. Now then, and then once you've done that, you can discard any cards you don't want, and then you draw up to 7. Now, of course, if you discard cards, that's eating through your decks, which will be a bit careful about. Okay. So, right. This is a boat. you can't see this, but this is a boat. This is a tank. These are your sea forces and your land forces. And they represent, they don't just, they're not just a tank. They represent your supply chain.
I want to freeze, I need Jesus.
So when we check to make sure that your forces are in supply, basically you have to draw a line of supply back to a supply point. So for example, if I put some tanks on the board like this, so my forces now stretch all the way up to Siberia, and they are all in supply because they all stretch to China. If someone is able to knock out my forces in Mongolia, suddenly Siberia is not in supply. So at the point in the turn where you check for supply, this would be out of supply and it would be removed from the board.
Alright?
There is one extra rule for sea spaces. So with tanks you just have to draw a line of supply. With sea spaces, so for example, if I just put a supply line in here, so I've got a tank in Japan, I've got a boat in the Sea of Japan, and then I've got a boat in North Pacific. Now, in order for this boat to be in supply, I have to have an allied, or sorry, a friendly troop on a land mass nearby. So the solution would be to put a tank in Iwo Jima, and now this is in supply. But it doesn't actually matter, so long as someone, one of my friends, so how you would do it, but... actually, we've got these. Colours confused.
Oh no!
There we go. Look,
you're the reds.
There you go. You're that's the Soviets.
Ah, hello.
So if somehow, I've no idea how. If Germany managed to get a tank in Iwo Jima, that would be fine. That would mean this boat is in supply.
Likely to happen.
Not likely to happen.
Not likely.
Okay. So that's pretty much it for supply. Right, cards. I'm going to pick up my deck. There are several different types of cards, and I'll just go over them. So this is a build army card. Essentially, it builds an army. It puts one of your tanks in a space that's or occupied by a friendly force. It has to be, because you're building the army, it has to be in the supply. Okay. Then you've got build navy. Same thing, you're building a navy in the city. Again, it must be in the supply. You then have land battle. You can battle a land piece that you are adjacent to. Now, you can use a boat to land people adjacent to a tank. You can use tanks to battle those tanks. It's the piece you're attacking that's important. And there is also a corresponding sea battle piece as well. So if someone plays with sea battle, you can battle a piece of sea on the boats, and again that can be from the tank. Remember, they are just representative of your forces. But you then have events, and like they suggest, I do not have a single event. Let's go through Italy, see if Italy's got some events. Italy has an event card, there we go. So that's an event card. Read the card, follow the instructions. Obviously, only play it if it's relevant. Okay. You then have status cards. So event happens and goes away. It's a one-shot thing. Status is an ongoing effect that lasts for the entire game. If you play this, then you are going to basically get some benefit. Okay, so they're pretty good. And then you have response. So a response card is the only card that's ever going to have an effect out of turn. To play a response card, you put it on your turn, you put it face down in front of you. That's now ready. It's like a trap card. That's now ready to be used. The conditions for playing it will be on the card. So essentially, if you fulfill the conditions, you can flip it over and follow the effects. One note on this, it is possible to battle an empty space. So sometimes responses will say, if you battle a sea space, do X. Well, you can then use a sea battle space, even if there's no one there, to activate a response. It's a bit of a waste. Okay. Finally, economic warfare. This essentially hits the homeland of the troops involved. And this is about milling them. So taking cards off the top deck and putting them into the graveyard. If I'm honest, this is actually, I suspect these are probably used towards the end of the game when someone's running low and you can actually take points away from them. So I would hang on to these.
Or
discard them. Yeah, there are some nukes in there, definitely. Right, who's, I've got a, did I not pick up a, I've got a cards, or did I give it back to you?
I don't know. I don't know, Glenn.
I'm not really sure what's going on anymore. I might give it back to you.
Yeah. I'm ready to play cards.
Yeah, okay. You start playing.
About 20 minutes ago, and I'm now more confused than I was to start with.
Okay, we won't worry about any of these. These rules don't affect you. Don't worry about
like
these. Nothing to do. It's all right. So at the end of the phase, you're going to score. You score 2 points for every supplied space that you control. Plus your statuses will give you extra points as well. Okay. Do make sure you do that. And then finally, that's kind of it. Let's not worry about it. Right, let's just go. So you want to shuffle your deck and make sure that you're all nice and ready to go. Right, you need to put a piece in your home space. So every army gets a piece. There are lots of rules I haven't told you, but to give myself an advantage, I'm just going to keep them to myself, and I'll tell you guys as and when you break them.
I see Glenn's going to win it for me. He's on Team Bane.
Come on, the Allies!
It's just so going down.
I don't believe it. This time, it is my time.
Do we count this towards the graduation?
No. Right. So, for each deck, deal 10 cards down.
You can't count that high. Yeah.
Have a look.
I'm rubbish at dealing.
Oh, I got all the
scores. Five, six, can you find one of those?
Nine, ten. I'm nearly there.
Have a look at your hands. Discard three.
I haven't even dealt with cards yet.
You got more armies than everybody else.
I'm exhausted.
That's quite tricky.
Do you have to discard three? Do you
have to discard three.
Oh, that's terrible.
So just because the camera can't necessarily see, I'm going to discard an economic war, a response, and a build. So what are you guys discarding? Let's have a look. Now, strictly speaking, you're not allowed to look at each other's cards, but I'm not doing that. You're going to discard a... Ooh, you discard that.
Is that not good?
Oh, no, I'm just winding out.
Don't do that to me!
Okay.
Hang on, look, this is going to take me some time.
This is going to be funny because you've got to play three hands at once.
You've got to be well coordinated, Carl. It's going to be a thing. It's going to be a thing.
That's all.
That one.
He wants to destroy these.
I want that.
You might want to remove the beer from the table so that you're going to give yourself a bit of space.
Loads of room.
I just want to do it
in case. Get rid of beer?
How do you put it on a floor? Don't get rid of it. You want to drink it? You can just drink it.
He's going to be drinking
it. For? I don't know. You asked for that. Let's have a look.
These are the ones I'm going to get rid of.
So build that. Build Navy. In the landlocked United States, you're going to get rid of Build Navy. Sure, that seems good.
I've got loads of
land battle aircraft carriers.
Okay. I can tell he disagrees with me here.
I'm actually going to go for that. I'm alright with that.
For the record, I've only played that size myself, so I've got no idea what I'm doing either.
But what are we getting these cards? We got rid of them. What's happening?
Face up next to your deck to perform a discard pile.
Okay.
So if you perform a discard pile for both of your decks, keep your hand
separate. Okay. Have you not ordered yet? I think you ordered
it. Right. I'm still working this one.
Some people take forever.
Remember, guys, if you're joining us, let us know. We will try to get better microphones. I do apologise if there's a lot of background noise because this is a very busy shop because it's such an awesome place to be. So if you're ever in Gravesend, make sure you check out the Mug and Meeple. It is on Facebook. We will put the link in the description. So do come and say hello if you're close. That means you see the Legion, because I know you're only in Rochester. So it's over that far for you.
We've got loads of wargaming supplies for saying, loads of wargames, everything you need. Online shop, they'll put a link in the description. I'll make it.
It'll all be there for you guys. So if you are ever down here in the southeast of the United Kingdom, even if you're travelling from a faraway land, come see the Mug and Meeple. And maybe see Bane. Bane is here a lot.
You don't want to see
painting.
Painting. A lot of bothers. That's where I am when I'm not YouTubing. I don't know where he is. Jimin.
We keep him in the dungeon.
What?
He's got a little cage.
You done yet?
No.
Alright, you've got to show me your cards.
Yeah, well, that's going to help. Oh, you're taking that one, are you?
Yeah, right, okay. Ah, see what you discarded there. That's
cool.
Done, he's done. He's
right, we're good. Okay. So.
Oh, wow.
Ooh. Face up on the cheating.
Face up.
Not that we're going to check them. Yeah, you're probably a good idea to put them in
place. This is all very challenging for me.
You can put them in one pile, you don't need to pack them out.
Oh, thank the good Lord.
Boom! I'm back!
Oh no, keep them separate. Keep them separate. So, otherwise the deck will get confused. You can just put them in pile there. Cool, okay.
We're not right.
So, Germany. It is your go. You get to start. Because you did start the war, to be fair. It was your fault. So, just to go through the turn order again. First thing you do is lay a card and play a card. So choose what you want to do. Top tip, you need to expand in Europe as quick as you can because the Allies are coming for you.
I know what I'm going to do. I'll play the card down.
Play it down, yeah. Build army, okay? So, put an army on a space next to Germany. Adjacent space. Seems like a good play because it gives you points.
Okay,
so then we go to the supply step. All of your armies are in supply, so don't need to worry about that. Collect victory points. You currently have 4 because you're in 2 supply spaces, so 2 points. Axis. Discard step.
2 points or 4 points?
2. 4, sorry. Did I say 2?
You said 2.
Bad me. Right. Now, is there any cards you want to discard? Or are you happy with it? Remember, limited card pool.
I thought you had to have all 4 points.
Yeah, I do.
Okay. Put it face up in your discard pile. And then now you draw up to 7. So you can draw 2. Okay.
It's not going well for him.
And now it's the United Kingdom's turn, so same thing for you.
Rule Britannia! Britannia rules the waves!
I got so focused on
I knew he was going to do that.
Thanks for the heads up, guys. Appreciate it.
that was impromptu. That wasn't even planned.
Thank you for making me a pirate.
Are you building a navy? That seems like a really clever idea.
It's something that we never expected Britain to
do. What? Britain build a navy?
Navy?
Who would have thunk it?
A navy? Put him there.
A navy.
I'll have to check whether I need to discard any cards, don't I?
What about that one?
I could discard the card that allows me to discard cards. No, I'll be fine.
Okay, you're good. Okay. So, you're in supply, that's no problem. Victory step, collect your victory points.
Oh yes, so
2.
I've only got the 2 there.
Where's me?
There, it's on the board. Look, allies.
Oh my god.
2, terrible.
Okay, and then you draw a step, so draw up to 7.
How many have
you got in your hand?
It's going to be a long night. It's
going to
be a very
long night. I can have one of them.
Yep. Okay, then we are over to Japan, which is me. I am going to similarly build a navy. I will not discard, so I will then. I am in supply. I get 2 victory points, so you can move the axis up 2 victory points. And then I will draw, and I am done. And then we are on to the Soviet Union.
Magnificent. Right. It's way easy to do a Soviet Union. There's nothing.
Just a thing. Probably a good idea to try and like plan your move before I tell you it's your go. Just saying. Like when other people are saying it's taking you go.
I'm snappy.
So what are we going to do? It's like, I get Glenna to tell me off if I don't get Italy ready.
I built an army on Ukraine and collect a couple of points there. Do I want to discard any cards? I'll check that.
You're in supply when you're doing that, and you've now got 2 spaces. So I will put you up 4 points. You've got 6, same as us.
I know what I'm going to do. I'm there. Italy is there.
The job of Italy is to support Germany. And it, like the job of the United States is to support the United Kingdom.
I'm not going to do well with that.
Just giving you a tip.
I got it. It's the Italy's turn now. Yes. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to build an army. We're taking the Balkans.
Yeah. got a tank to the Balkans. Right, so that was terrible. It's in supply. Collect victory points. Get 2 victory points. Do you wish to discard?
I actually don't think I do.
Okay, so draw a card, and you are done, and we are over to the United States.
America! Fuck yeah!
I thought we weren't swearing enough.
Oh, sorry, that was swearing.
Bleep yeah.
Bleep yeah!
Now, just to confirm, before we go any further, supposing I have a supply chain that is both myself and allied, does that
no your supply chain in the war? Every nation uses their own supply chain, so must you. The only exception is the boats. The boats can be resupplied by any friendly.
How long, then? I know that America gave us tanks in the war.
It's different from having a supply chain, Keith. You should know.
Okay. I was trying to be clever there.
I'd stop that right now. You want to hide into nothing, mate.
So we'll create an army over there.
Not be clever at all.
Right.
I need to check my discard cards. My apologies. That's.
Can't find the gamers these days.
Three. So, what we're actually going to do is we will discard this one.
What are you discarding? You need to tell the people.
I'm discarding pattern advances. Because we all know that pattern advances are unwelcome.
According to one of the presidents, potential presidents of the United States, it's perfectly fine.
There we go. We've taken cards and we're cooking.
Yes.
We're cooking with it.
No cheating.
Well, I've got victory points.
Don't forget your victory points. You're 4 now, so you're in the lead.
God damn it, stop it!
Right, so because that was the United States and you're all done, you need to move the turn marker on one. And we go back to the top with Jimmy.
Okay, this is what's going to happen. We're feeling aggressive. We're going to do a land battle. Tyson!
I thought you said we were out of bearing.
It's fine.
Against
YouTube Ukraine.
Yeah, that's right. So essentially, there's no rolling of dice or anything like that. Ukraine's just destroyed because you've got a land battle.
That's basically because of initiative, is it?
No, it's just the way the game works. The game is very simple, yeah.
You no longer have the Ukraine, I do.
No, you don't have it either. You have to build into it to get it. Okay, so Germany, do you take your points so you get 2 points for Germany? No, 4 points for Germany, sorry. Do you want to discard any cards and then draw up? And then it is the go of the United Kingdom. You can start taking the cards.
Let's take a look.
Up to 7. So you discard one. You got 7.
Alright, in that case we're going to be having a land battle using this fellow here who is a boat. He's quite literally going to land on Western Europe.
D-Day has begun!
It's just shelling.
Just shelling. So, presumably, I get some points for that. Is that just
no?
Two?
You get nothing for that because you are not occupying Western Europe. It's just that Germany is no longer occupying it either.
Totally unfortunate for me.
You have to both battle and land forces.
But I do need to take a card.
You need to take a card.
I don't want to discard anything.
Okay. So score your points. So you get 2 points.
You get 2. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So Japan is next, and Japan, unsurprisingly, will be building an army in China. I will be not discarding any cards, I'll be drawing a card, I'll be taking some victory points, so I'll be getting 4. 16. And I am done. I'm up to 7. Did I draw? I did draw, so it is
Soviet Union.
Soviet Union.
Okay, let's see what the Soviets can do. I'm sure they can do something. Well, realistically speaking, we can't do anything. So, what I'll have to do is I'll have to look at my cards.
I'll say try looking for a response or a status, something that'll save up for later on.
Dixit?
You don't necessarily have to do something right now, but you remember if you lose your capital, that's kind of bad.
It is. I think what we might do is we might set this aside for later.
So that's a response.
That is a response.
Right, so make sure, might be a good idea to try and put that somewhere that's a bit more visible.
Okay, so
show that you have a response. Anyway, just
move these things out of the way.
There's definitely not the purchased here things.
People are going to start believing you did actually purchase this stuff here. I genuinely did purchase this stuff.
Yeah.
Italy.
No, not
Italy. Points. Don't forget points. Yes, you must get points. Must collect points.
Well.
You've got lots of options here, Italy. Look, Ukraine is open.
I am going to actually build an army.
Which way are you going?
It's got to be on the Ukraine. Surely.
I think you're right. I think that's the way to go. So 4 points to Italy. Takes us to 20.
Okay.
And then it's over to the United States. United States. I should actually start playing one.
In my head, I was like,
you know what?
I'll become too much. I shall build a navy. And we'll pop him right about here.
Ooh, them's farting words. Okay. All right, it's on. It is definitely on.
I'm going to discard this one. Oh, no. To be truly discarded.
It's been thrown.
And grab a couple more. Neither of which are of any use. It's important to know that. And I do need 4 points now, don't I? Still lagging behind, but...
Okay, because you're done, we have the turn marker on one, and we are back to the top, and it is Germany.
Ooh, so I think I'm going to play an event, because I guess that's really... Oh, no, actually, I'm not going to play an event. Oh, I shall retrieve it. That helps me do two. So I'm going to play this event. Recruits one or two armies adjacent to Germany.
Yep, that seems good. Germany's this one. Because we each have different levels of supply. So, for example, United Kingdom, Japan have got more boats, Germany has more tanks.
There we go.
Okay, Germany scores four.
Very good.
Axis are taking an early lead. Right, do you want to discard any? And if not, draw up seven.
I'm quite happy with my cards.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, so that was Germany, United Kingdom.
Right. The United Kingdom. He's very reactionary at the moment. I don't like being reactionary. It's very troubling for me.
Well, we are the aggressor. Superior aggressor. We'll just wait for Gull to decide.
Just talk amongst yourselves.
I'm deciding.
Look, this seems to be a really good game, you know? I'm quite enjoying it.
It's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, we sell loads of these in our web store. Link below.
Loads of them. Now, can I choose this as a land battle at the top here? Is that allowed?
Yeah, absolutely. Because you're adjacent, you can land battle from the boat, so that's fine.
Fantastic. So we'll move this again.
Yep. That happens a lot. Right? This is going to go on a lot. It is literally here.
Stop shelling my guys, man.
Take the 2 points, and then I'm just going to take a quick look here.
Oh, this is my go.
It's going to take me 3 days. I like both of those. That seems
what,
no good to
what
me.
Are the Japanese going to do?
Right, so we've got two new cards.
Done?
Yes.
Japanese are going to lay a response.
Oh.
And then they are going to have a quick look.
With all their cards.
I'm going to discard this. And then I'm going to draw two. I'm going to take 4 victory points, please. And then I'm going to pass the turn to the Soviet Union.
Stra! Let's take a look and see if I can do anything useful at all. We'll leave that one for the moment. We don't want to play that event yet.
Get more money. Two hunters, two shadows.
I'm so unsure of what to do.
I'm terrified.
What can I say? He's a terrible player.
Just absolutely terrifying. We're once again going to just smack the Greg.
No. Thanks!
Any time.
And now it's Italy?
Italy.
So I'm going to play an event and I'm going to recruit a German army in North Africa. I'm going to recruit a German navy in the Mediterranean.
Yes.
So, Mediterranean.
There's a problem. Well, you'll be out of supply. Now, you can do it, but instantly you'll be out of supply.
Because I can't regrow from there. Right?
No, the way to fix that is you would need to be in Western Europe. Or... Anyway, moving swiftly on. If you put these two armies there, you've got no connection to any supply route. So you can't be resupplied by a friendly force. It has to be your own forces.
I can't do it.
No. Well, you can. It would be a terrible move.
I won't do it then.
Don't do that.
What are you going to do then? I don't know. I might find something else. This has thrown me now. Okay. I will instead build a navy in the Mediterranean Sea.
Oh, wait, do you know? Oh, no, that's right, yes, because you're building a German army.
Yeah.
Yes, you can totally build an Italian navy in the Mediterranean Sea. That totally works.
Yes, I can, I am Italy.
Yep, you definitely. Right, so discard, draw, all of that jazz, score points. Italy currently has 2 points, so 2 points to Italy.
What's wrong with Italian navy?
And then it is United States.
It is the United States. Let's see what we can do. Once again, my climbing's shining through. Oh! Not sure I'm ready for any of this. This is struggling, right? What we'll do?
You know what you are.
We're going to recruit an available Soviet army in Russia.
Okay.
Put that down there. And there it lies.
Okay. Score points. You get 4 points.
4 points. I will take a card as well. It's 4 points as a Soviet.
No, that was not Soviet. That was United States, wasn't it? You made a Soviet army, but he's got this place.
What, the Americans just gave the Soviets? I don't get this. What world is this we're playing in?
They're sending arms and stuff.
Right, okay. I better get ready for my next wartime event.
Did you not?
Right, so that was the United States. Move the turn marker on.
Oh, yes.
You scored, didn't you?
Good. I'm lagging behind though, quite badly.
Join the niche.
This is throwing me out. I think I am going to, instead of playing a card from my hand, is that a status, yes?
Yeah, so you just play that and it stays in front of you. And what does it do?
Instead of playing a card here and discard the top two cards of your draw deck. This one here.
But no, you can do that. So instead of playing a card from your hand, discard the top two cards of your draw deck. No, but you've played that this turn.
Oh, right. So
that is the card you can get next turn.
I'm with it. I'm okay.
My
right, so score. Germany?
2 points. So I get 2 points.
I should be reminding them every time. I know what I'm doing.
Yeah. You reminded us to score points.
Score on us, I'm right.
Do you need to take any more cards on?
Okay.
Oh, I'm getting that.
United Kingdom.
Right then.
Good old Blighty.
Blighty is ready for their invasion. We shall build an army, and we shall build it in Western Europe.
Now D-Day's begun.
D-Day has actually begun.
It just got real. I'll take a card. And we will score some points as well. 4 points, and over to you, sir.
Okay, so, did you draw?
I did.
Okay, so I am going to
massacre you.
No, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to play a status. During your victory step, during the victory step of your turn, gain plus one victory points for each army you have in Indonesia, New Guinea, and Southeast Asia. So Indonesia, which is here, New Guinea, and Southeast Asia, which is currently none. I will also be discarding. Oh, mate, within 2 seconds, I'll be discarding a land battle, and I'll be scoring 4 points for the axis, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I will be drawing 2 cards, and then serving a customer.
Alright, are we all good?
I'm done.
And
good.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen. It is now the Soviet Union's turn. So I've already chosen what I'm going to do for the first time. And I'm going to build an army in, rather unsurprisingly for the Soviet Union, the Ukraine.
Don't like it.
I've already taken the additional cards that are required. So I'll take the points, which will be 4. There we go. And that will end my turn.
Yeah. Oh. Some choices going on in Italy.
There we go. Incoming communication.
Incoming communications. I think actually that I'm going to do a land battle. And I'm going to destroy the army in the Ukraine.
Who'd have thought that was what?
Like, who would have guessed it?
Right, okay. So points, Italy 2.
Just 2 now. I was going to go like,
and we are on to the United States. Okay.
United States of America!
Sadly, I'm in a very good position. Let's just see what I can do.
What are you going to do, girl? What are you going to do?
Hopefully roll over and lose the war.
Is the United States of America giving up?
Okay, I'm going to play an event. I'm going to play it immediately. The United Kingdom can immediately build an army and a navy.
So the United Kingdom can immediately build an army and a navy. The units must be built in the order of the United Kingdom players' choice.
Indeed, sir. So here's what I'm going to do, sir. I'm going to put a navy.
Yeah.
I'm going to build an army.
So, quick point, this is in supply because it's touching the
Just to confirm what I'm doing, I'm also going to pop an army there in Scandinavia.
Now that means that he controls the strait, so these two sea spaces are only adjacent to the allies.
I don't like it, he's getting close to Germany.
You need to do something like that. I'm over here just doing my own thing.
Italy's okay, but Germany's having a bit of a...
I've taken my card, and the US, of course, gets 4 victory points. There we go.
I hope so.
Now we're back to Germany, we're going to go forward to Germany.
Yes, so go on one. I think Japan needs to enter this war, doesn't it?
I think it does.
I disagree wholeheartedly.
I think the Americans need to slap him.
Whole-leggedly. That's what I disagree with.
Three seconds? Drew. Three seconds? Drew. Why?
Okay. I think I've chosen well, only playing one country. That's definitely something.
I'm going to discard. I'm going to use my status.
Yep.
Instead of a card, I'm going to discard the top two cards of my deck.
Yep, so against the bin.
And I'm going
to
build army.
No, you don't need to pull it. You just perform the build army.
You just
build army.
Oh, in Ukraine.
Yeah. On the Ukraine.
Yeah. Okay, so Germany scores 4 points. It's certainly my favourite. Okay, and we are over to United Kingdom.
For the Lord!
Well, let's see what I can do here. Now, this is another one of those things that I need to do.
You did this! You did this! You set me up!
If we choose sea battle at this point in time, can I attack from sea onto land?
No, sea battle is battling a sea piece.
Okay.
It's worth pointing out that these straits here both are closed to us because we have to control the strait in order to go through it, but the allies there are open. So in theory, you could battle this space actually, battle the Mediterranean, because you are in the North Sea.
That is true. But is that currently of any use to us?
No. You could do that. That is a thing that you could do.
Yes, waste your turn by battling something insignificant.
Gee, thanks.
I'm sure the Allies never did any of that.
I think what I'm actually going to do is limited. I'm going to play this status card, leave it face down for the time being. I'm going to discard. Abysmal, by the way. And I'll take my 4 points.
Okay, Japan. Japan will. Actually, Japan's not going to do what it was going to do because it's realised it can't. So, Japan is going to build an army in Southeast Asia.
Very good.
Now, because I got my status out, I'll give an extra point for that. So, scores plus 5. And I'm beginning to think that a lot of my cards are a bit irrelevant. I don't want to get rid of them.
Chainsaw!
I'm going to discard that and I'm going to draw 2.
She said,
and I'm done.
Soviet
Union.
Soviet Union. Soviet Union.
Rather unsurprisingly, he's going to play land battle.
I feel a theme.
It's definitely. It's almost like there is a war in Europe.
And it's like remove the troops from the Ukraine. And in addition to that, I'm not sure that these are going to be any use to me at present. We're going to discard 2 and pick up
3. Wow, you're discarding the sea battles things. Oh, it's from Russia, isn't it? Oh yeah,
it's from the Soviet Union.
Yeah, that seems perfectly reasonable.
Oh good, we've got build navy. Fantastic.
Well, you could build in the Black Sea or something, you know, the Caspian Sea, you know, those major military theatres of war. Italy.
Italy?
Okay, confused. Oh, well, this one's very, very straightforward. What I'm going to do...
I have a feeling I know what you might do.
I'm going to build an army.
An army? This is great. Score 4.
See what I did there?
Draw cards, discard cards, all that jazz. United States.
The United States is going to build a navy. Which is
this should be interesting.
Relatively unsurprising. It's going to get killed immediately.
Depends on where you put it. I can't put it there.
Why not?
So I'm in the Sea of Japan.
That's his sea!
Get off my land! Get off my land!
In that case, bits. We'll go down here.
I won't do that either.
No, am I still? Like, do I need a land bridge?
You need a tank.
I'm not going to build.
No, I didn't.
I was just testing you.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, sure. Yeah, of course. I get that.
The US is going to build an army, which is what I intended all along.
But it was you.
Okay.
That's fairly unlikely, so we'll get rid of this one.
Your status is stat. Can state
yeah.
both.
Yeah, okay. The more you have, the better it is. And all of mine, because I know I've got loads of them, are in the bottom half of my deck, which is not great.
So can you play a status and lay a card, or can you do one?
Can I do one card a turn? So we are at the end of the turn, so I'm going to turn the turn marker on. And it is Germany.
So if I had a status, if I built an army using this card, I could have a
proper status. You can't remember playing a card and using a card are different. Status is something you use.
In what sense?
Yeah. So let me have a quick read.
See why I'm interested.
Yes, you can stack them, but you will need to play this so that they're both in play, and then on future turns.
Yeah. So I will play a status card.
Alright.
I'm not going
to
tell you what it does.
No, no, you have to. You can't hide status cards. Those are response cards.
Oh,
I have one of those hidden as well.
Alright, okay.
Here they are.
Germany not really contributing to this war. I'm very disappointed with the.
But I'm very happy with Italy at the moment.
Italy seems to be.
Germany will contribute very soon.
Right. Okay. And we are on to the United Kingdom.
I was contributing to the war, but someone kept destroying everything.
It's all right. Italy's taking the slack for you. That's fine.
Ukraine has been battled many times now. Held by many.
It has. Sadly.
So what is the United Kingdom doing?
We're going to play this status card, which is it allows me to build space in India without supply.
Oh, really? Okay.
It forces his hand to take India, which is exactly what he's going to do anyway.
No, I'm still going to do what I was going to do, which is quite funny. It's my turn. Have you done your points? What points did you score?
My only score? Oh, I do score four.
Yeah, so what? Yeah. Three cards. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and do this. So, I welcome to build armies in India, so I can kick them up and down the map. Just like I'm about to do to you, so... I'm going to sea bow over here and destroy this, and then, oh, what is this? When you battle a sea space, you may battle an additional navy, even if you don't have one, and then battle an army. Oh, so sorry.
I'm all right with that.
So sorry.
We needed their resources.
Yeah, right, whatever. Consider yourself removed from Iwo Jima. And it is Soviet Union. Oh, Scott, more points. Oh, I've got five.
You don't require any points.
I feel like Japan's taken 5 points a turn. Come on. Because I've got one, two, and then I get a point for this because my status card.
Right, okay. Japan is helping out.
We are doing our bit.
You've got to stop Japan, bro.
Great squad. I can do right now.
I really want to get over here. So badly want to get over here, but it's quite difficult. If he's going to start building over here, I'm going to kick his ass over.
I can't even build an army, so all I can do is ask him to land back on and remove the Ukraine.
that is theme here.
Stop taking your crown!
Actually, I just realised I should discard some cards. I've got too much time to do that. Cheating, cheating.
Right, so, who's is it? Jeremy or is
it? I need some points.
Take 2 points, 2 points.
I'm moving back to Germany again, right?
No, that's over you, isn't it?
Yeah.
So Italy.
Italia. Oh, well.
If you'd like to build an army in the Ukraine, that would be fine.
Well, I could do that, ironically. I could do that.
That doesn't suck. It's 2 points every time you do that, so that's absolutely fine. Also, kicking someone out of Western Europe would be hilarious.
But there is something better I can do.
And I suppose Italy's got no, you can't do that.
I'm going to play an event, actually. Okay, and what that's going to do is it's going to score me 1+1 for each Italian army and navy outside. So there's two.
You mean to gain 1 victory point for each Italian army and navy outside
Italy? Two, and two.
No, because that one's in Italy. Oh, so plus your two for the thing. Yeah, I got you. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. Draw a card, and it's United States.
US.
Are
you the
US is busily being hamstrung. It's, let's do some stuff. Are you the same one? Here. I'm going to build a navy.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
He's expanding.
All right. Back to the top, so do you want to turn marker on? How many points?
Four. So,
you move on, yeah. So, German.
So, I'm going to activate the cards, I'm going to play in the card in my hand. Is this one or two cards?
Remember, you've got a limited card to be decided. Be careful.
I know, it's a reason. Yep. It allows me to build an army. So, I also have another status. So, I'm going to build an army, and this card that's activated allows me to battle an allied army adjacent to me. So, I'm going to battle
Moscow.
Moscow.
Moscow is destroyed.
As a response, I would like to do not remove an army in Moscow.
Oh!
Oh! Waiting for you.
What a trap. What a trap.
That's a shame, because that would have been out of supply as well, so it would have been 2 minutes.
So I am going to score 4 points. Though.
You asked for 4 points.
That was a good play.
Well, he's made him use it. He's made him use it, and you can do it again next turn so far, unless, you know, it may well happen.
Right, so I'm back to...
Have you drawn up?
I need to pull another card.
Okay. No, you didn't play. You didn't play one. All right. Okay. So we are on United Kingdom. Yeah, that was Germany, wasn't it? United Kingdom.
UK. I'll ignore that. Me?
Why me?
Just testing.
Yeah, of course. Is that Alpha Budweiser in everywhere? I said, you aren't that Alpha Budweiser in everywhere.
He's drunk.
No, you're in defence.
Free France, which... So is there a valid card in your hand? Discard two cards from your hand and build an army in Western Europe, which you already have.
It's
in the future. It's in the future, in case we take what
you
read.
Which you will. You're in the driving seat there right now, so it's a fair
play. So Japan... I can't really avoid doing this. I'm taking India.
I thought it would be.
I've got to stop you using your ability, so we will go ahead and do that.
Immediately eliminate an Axis army built on recruiting in India, Australia.
Oh! I'll just have to do it again next turn.
Dear,
and I will draw just the one. score points. I'm still scoring five. And I've drawn, so I'm good to go. And then it's Soviet Union.
Soviet?
This is going very well for us.
Oh, Soviet.
You've got no more responses, right?
No more handbook.
Okay, this is good. No more hidden responses.
I'm on six. Let me call it down.
So there are used to it.
You can go.
Yeah.
Literally just the.
I'm going to play this event, which is to recruit the Soviet army in Vladivostok and eliminate an enemy army in China.
Oh! Puts you out of
it does.
Where's Vladivostok?
But it's like, but that doesn't get taken away until my turn. So I could in theory, back into China.
It's over here. Now, it's not in. Is that an issue?
Oh, yeah.
So it's immediately taken away.
The hell yeah.
It's not the end of the world.
No, I will build it from here. Hope.
Oh, I hope I can.
Show me who you are.
Okay. I need 2 points if I'm
able to. Oh, no.
Two points for the Allies.
For the Allies.
Oh, shout I'm in trouble.
How many late cards do you have? Shit.
Oh dear, right. Oh, I think. Is it Italy? Is it Italy? Right, so Italy's turn, yeah?
Italy, who was that? That was, who was that? I forgot.
That was
Vladivostok. That was like Ireland's reaction to any war.
Soviet Union, wasn't it?
Was that Soviet Union? So we are on to Italy.
No.
I'm going to lay this response card.
Okay, so that's all you do.
But I want to discard something.
Okay, that you can do.
That's because all you've got is events.
I have not.
Can I have my comic?
It's getting a bit tight for the Soviet Union right now.
In all fairness, what I've just done should have shown who I am.
Yeah.
I know who you are.
United States.
Why?
America!
Fiddle, yes. Well. Nothing.
If you could just enter this war, that would be great. I mean, anytime.
I'm really trying.
I mean, you know, you've kind of floated around over here for a bit, and you float around over there for a bit. What have you actually done, America? Right, okay. Pull your weight.
I'm just checking out
the biggest industrial nation in the world. Come on.
If you are American, we wish a majority of you will be watching our channel. I apologise on behalf of the girl.
No, I am.
For not playing America as you deem your nation to be played in World War II.
The US is going to build an army. America!
That's not unreasonable.
Is it? If you know the cards.
There we go. Yeah, I'll take the cards.
He's kind of just avoiding it.
What? This is what the US did.
I'm actually very tempted to ignore what I was doing over here and come take this out. Because that's funny.
I'd be really sad about that.
Yeah, I thought you might.
I think we should do it.
Can I have 4 points?
You can have 4 points.
Yeah, thank you.
If only my cards allowed me to do such a thing. Right, okay, so we move the turn marker on and we are back to join. And I think I know what Joymany is going to do.
Is he going to be playing it?
Well, I didn't do the same you did last turn, personally.
Yeah,
I think you do that.
I'm going to discard two cards
and do a thingy.
I'm going to build an army.
Do you build an army?
Yeah, build an army. Oh, you're allowed to immediately attack an army in an adjacent square, which will be Moscow.
So Moscow loses out.
Oh, wait, have you got your response cards?
Let's just take a look at
you. No, you haven't. Yeah, I haven't.
However, do you get to build an army as well? No, you built one already.
I built one, that was one. I built one there.
Okay.
Which is still
very good.
So,
and also,
although this is not in supply, we don't check for supply until your turn, so you can still get it back in.
Still again,
4 points. 4 points, the access. I feel good about this.
Axis still in the lead. Okay, United Kingdom.
What I'm planning to do is I'm planning to form a crater in Moscow so I can build a main next turn.
That's as good as it's going to get.
And if you support it, it turns back. That's right.
Hmm? Yeah.
Except
the fact
that's the only one. Yeah.
And because
I think not a great deal of use going on at the moment.
What's the like end purpose of this?
When? Again,
he's dead. You mean good?
I'll go to sleep. Yeah. Okay, that's the next.
I'm going to count how many cards I have left to see if I've got enough.
Whoa! Rock's Prodigal is not conducive to me at all, so I'm going to get rid of the card.
Yeah, but they're
not
cool
tokens. It becomes the same card as the one I have.
Are you dead? James specifically.
Have you done yet?
Yep. No, it's very little like me.
It's all getting serious now. It's actually thinking about what it's doing.
Can you get a gift?
Should have to get someone to bring in some dummy leaf for you downstairs.
It's needed.
What can I do now? I'm in trouble. All I can really do
is. This is my hand.
That's alright.
Have we got maybe?
Yeah.
Not one. Down here in Northampton.
Okay. It's quite
aggressive.
Who's
turning
it? I am going to lose.
You do need 4 points. 1, 2, 3.
I'm not. I am going to play a response.
Every round?
Then I'm going to. Oh, look at these. I'm going to discard this and draw two. And then I'm going to gain. A measly. This is going to go out of supply, and I'm going to gain a measly 2 points.
You're pulling your weight now, are you?
I'm not pulling my weight anymore.
Right. Alright, over to.
You're going to have to play a response card for Moscow.
And you're going to lose Russia then?
Oh.
Russia.
Oh, now this is bad because you need to control Moscow. You can't score any points as the Russians.
I'm fully aware of this. Sadly, but I can't build an army, so.
You cannot build an army. See that? Brilliant.
Now remember, we can win the game if we occupy two opposing forces. So if you take Moscow, hold Moscow, and let's say took the United Kingdom, we would just straight win.
Alright, get the steam going, okay?
I could try and come take this. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen.
Germany, is it?
It is.
No, what was that? That was Italy.
Oh, it's Italy. Italia! Oh, do you know what? This is
like to play an event?
Good hand, Keith. Useful.
So it is Italy's go and Italy shall have a land battle.
Is it in Ukraine?
he's not in the Ukraine.
Oh, I can't think of
that. What's going to happen? They're going to fire and all that stuff. Destroy the
Because you can.
Because you can.
Why not?
Don't like it.
Right, draw a card. Score points. Italy, you are on 2 points. So Max is 2 points. And then it is the United States. Who have so far gone for a little drive. They're currently filming The Hobbit down in New Zealand.
Yeah.
And once they've made that terrible film, they're probably going to join the war.
I realise I'm technically not utilising part of this, but I'm playing a band in the US, which allows me to get an army in Hawaii and a navy in the North Pacific.
Cool, what's that?
It also allowed me to build one of the sandwiches. I'm going to also just start.
Yeah, you can.
I can't have two navies in some place.
You haven't got a navy in the South Pacific.
Be specific, please. I know what I meant.
Oh, okay.
Louder.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
It mumbles a lot.
I do, and I need 4 points.
So, 4 points.
4 points.
There was a one in three.
4 points.
Move the turn marker on, and it is Germany.
Germany.
We seem to be winning in Europe at the moment, but we do need to kick these pesky Tommies.
You see, I'm looking at my cards.
Card, which is immediately eliminated.
But can that trigger my response card?
Yes.
Because if you, when a German army is removed, it means you recruit an Italian army in the space. So,
That was it. Oh no, that's fine. Because you've got the, that's right.
There's no supply.
Yes, it is. It's his own supply.
Ooh, yeah. Fool ya!
Very well played, sir.
Did you see what I did there? Yeah. Now Italy.
Seems to be going quite well over there.
Right,
4 points. Moscow's in trouble. Like, Russia's in trouble.
But Russia's done. They can't do it.
I think Russia is done.
4 points to Germany.
4 points to Germany. And over to United Kingdom.
Come on, United Kingdom. What are you going to do now?
Not a lot, I don't think.
I heard something and I'm not telling you what it is.
Let's have a look.
Good to me. You could. You got build on. You could go to Russia.
I haven't got build on.
Try and reclaim Moscow. She put it to Russia. It's actually useful.
Well, I don't think it's going to be feasible, but we'll do it anyway.
Green now.
Where are they?
Yeah.
Here they are. So we'll go to Russia and see what happens.
Okay. Okay, Japan. Japan is going to lay another response card, and it's going to draw a card, and it's going to score two.
Are you kidding me?
And then Japan is done.
Okay.
Which brings us to the Soviets.
So you might want to sort of discard a few cards to see if you can dig to something that helps you.
Yeah. Let's just see if there's anything.
This is like
4 times. Realistically speaking, without these
Well, at the moment, right, you've had a card before that kicked some people somewhere out of Moscow, so you might be able to do it again.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, as always, Bane is being superior to the goal. Just remember this. I really think they should count towards Grudge Match.
I really think Bane shouldn't be on the channel, but
It's going to go back to just go gaming again, isn't it? GB
gaming.
It's
too late. Too late. People love you.
Do they?
I was going to say, at least someone does.
Yeah, at least. Access, I said.
I can do nothing.
You do nothing, right?
Right. So, if you can't play a card, you must discard one.
Oh, good.
I've already discarded three.
Oh, that's fine. If you discard three, that's fine.
Germany?
Italy.
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 Surprising. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to play an event which recruits an army in North Africa and an Italian navy in the Bay of Bengal.
Oh, that's interesting. Russia doesn't score any, so that's that.
I'm scoring four
points.
Because I hold Moscow. Four.
And then it is the United States.
Are the United States contributing to the war effort yet? I'm not feeling the pressure. United States of America, sitting on its own land. You got Hawaii. Yeah.
Let's hope you can swing out of the
line. It's no good to me.
I feel like Japan needs to.
Yeah, we need to launch out. Japan has got a plan.
Japan has a plan. You heard it here first, ladies and gentlemen.
We've expanded. We've got been back. We're about to expand again.
Okay.
Rapidly.
Okay. America.
I think I'm fucked, to be honest. No guards have been doing it.
You heard it first. Goals fucked.
Well, it'll be in a week.
Right, so let's just build a navy.
He does love his navy.
Oh, yeah, he's building out to Australia. Okay, that's what I'm doing.
It's pretty much all I can do.
Okay, so turn off goes on by one, and it is Germany.
It's the Germans!
We really need to start dealing with the UK.
I do. It's not as simple as it sounds, to be fair. I'm probably going to get rid of some cards, actually.
Alright.
I'm just going to... So I'm going to discard some of this one instead. I'm going to discard two from my deck.
Yep.
So this is eight. So there's one more.
I'm going to build an army.
Okay.
Which I will build here in Siberia.
That's a boat.
That's a boat, sorry.
They don't have boats in Siberia.
Here in Siberia, next to Kazakhstan.
Right.
And then attack Russia.
That seems fair.
Dealing with the... Get out of Russia.
That's an interesting way to get to Western Europe, via Siberia and Russia. Okay, that works. Right, United Kingdom.
Maybe that's where they went wrong. Maybe they should have done
it. Yeah, clearly.
I'm going to get rid of some cards.
Yeah, they're not that useful at this point.
Yeah, I nearly said
fine. Just get rid of these. These are of no use to me. Rather ironically for the United Kingdom, the build navy cards are of absolutely no use.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
You're not doing anything for United Kingdom then?
I'm going to. I'm just.
Well, you can't. You don't discard first. Draw. Do something first.
Oh, he's cheating again.
I mean, I personally think forfeit his go.
These are the two. In that case,
I am.
Realistically speaking, there's nothing I can do.
I wouldn't want you to claim you achieved that little victory this week. When we beat you fair and square.
I feel like I should have more.
Because Italy is known for its expansive forces. Don't think it actually expanded quite as wide as World War II.
I'm sure it could have done.
Don't think they did.
Oh God, Jesus!
Okay, alright. So, 4 points. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, Japan. Japan is going to land battle China.
So this takes away two things.
Then he's going to reply a response card.
You want to land battle China?
Yep. You can do that.
There's nothing there.
I know. When you battle in China, Sichuan, or Southeast Asia, you may build an army in a space battle. Then build an additional army in one of the other spaces. That gets me to five. If you could move me on, 5 points.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Look at this gap, ladies and gentlemen.
Are we
in the gap?
Are we 30 points ahead?
No, are we?
So we need to get to 108. So we are 14 points adrift. So we've still got a way to go yet.
And then it is Japan.
Japan is Soviet Union.
Sorry,
Mother Russia.
In Mother Russia, we cannot do nothing because we are occupied by the Italians.
Okay.
And surrounded by Germans.
Oh dear. I've got so many build army cards here as well, you wouldn't believe it.
5, 1 to 7.
That's no good to it. Let's get rid of birds. Again, get rid of that. Tough work for these. I've got another build army.
Okay, so Italy. The fabulous, fabulous Italians who could be tempted to get them.
I've got a Oh, whoa.
Oh, okay.
So, do I build one? But what I'm just going to do, actually, I do have a few ideas of what I want to do. Okay, so I'm going to do a land battle of the United Kingdom out of Western Europe.
Oh!
We've got three fronts.
Instead of playing a card from your hand, discard two cards from your hand.
That's
going to
be in the next
in your turn.
Okay. Well, we'll get there.
It's alright, that's okay. So restock for Italy.
Five yellow.
And then it is the United States.
Oh, good.
No, States of America!
Literally nothing. Well, come on, make America great again.
Well, I sincerely don't want to. It involves Trump. Let's build an army in Australia.
You know, like most of your
listeners. We have different views. I want to let live.
Six points.
Six points.
What?
Blimey. Yeah, you need to
kind of
do something about Australia.
Well,
shouldn't
be. Right, turn mark and move on. Germany.
We're going to build an army.
Western Europe.
Western Europe.
I can't believe that for a moment.
And Germany scores 6.
6. This is feeling good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're packing.
Right, flip the marker over. We are 100 points. Okay. So now we are on to United Kingdom.
We're on the United Kingdom, so no, I will actually play the three fronts.
What does it say?
We've got to discard two cards.
You can't, because you can't get rid of my army.
Yeah.
Oh, it's build an army. Destroy the existing army.
No.
Nothing good. In that case, well, I'm not.
I might play one of my cards. We're doing well.
Yeah.
Could be on for a point.
This event.
Eliminate an Axis army in China. Then recruit and available next strikes army in the Sichuan. So
this goes.
And then an American army appears here. America on the continent. America just entered.
We have
the...
no available.
Oh, America's army.
That doesn't matter. It's my turn. So yeah. Right, so that was America. What was that?
It was the UK.
It's me.
So I get 2 points.
So I'm going to immediately build my army. I'm not going to
do that.
And I will. Am I going to discard? I will discard this as well. I'm going to draw 2. I'm going to gain 7 victory points.
7 victory points. How do you feel, Gold?
Terrible.
And pass turn to the Soviet Union.
Oh,
it's like a little paper cut every time we say it. And it's like a little. Oh, is it some, it's the Soviet Union's turn.
Vodka.
Have a turn, Soviet Union. Take.
Build an army.
Show the camera.
Show the camera. How many build armies do you have, Go?
The Soviets would be in the driving seat had they got any land. I've got four build army.
So take your turn, Soviet Union.
Wait, to get rid of three of the build armies.
Is GB Gaming.
GB Gaming! This is so many. So, Goal, ladies and gentlemen, is not having a good game at this point, whereas the Axis are kind of like, here we are.
Use where you have a free land space. Well, I've got plenty as far as I can tell.
Yes!
That's my turn. Continue on.
Okay, so, Italy.
Italia, has a plan. This could ruin your day. So I'm going to commit a sea battle. Okay, this is big. And this fleet is going to knock
it
out.
And it can as well, because we control the Straits of North Africa.
That one. So goodbye. And that, I believe.
It does. So on England's turn, if they don't build a navy, they're in deep doo-doo.
Just going to take a quick look at the end.
If you've caught him without Bill maybe now, that's going to be hilarious. So those were the ones you were discarding earlier, saying how useless they were, weren't you? Yeah. Seems to remember that's all that was. Yeah.
This has gone badly.
Yeah, not doing so well. No.
Brilliant strategy.
Points.
Points. I'm sorry for you. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh,
and that was Italy.
Will it end?
Was that Italy? Okay, so
United States of America.
Who are pulling their weight and are scoring six.
They're about the only ones. What's this?
Have you got anything that can help the United Kingdom? Italian Navy just wiped out the British Navy.
But you know what? Let's leave these here just in case. Just in case.
Yeah, you might. Not that one. That one's in there. Don't cheat. He's putting his things in the wrong place.
Oh, no. He's cheating. Right, we're going to.
Very, very lovely.
Right. Actually, it's no good to me. The event is no good to me.
Taste of victory. Cheers, Axis buddy.
Which is ironic because I'm drinking Budweiser.
That's a good point. Yeah, French wine.
Right,
yeah, that's all right, that's okay.
Right. American beer.
Go, you're having a great game. Yeah. What's that? Oh, blimey, 90s reference.
Jeez.
Anyone under the age of 20 needs to go to YouTube and find out what that means.
What's up, man? Where's my
boy? What's up?
We're going to discard three cards and just pick up some more. That's good. That's the sea battle.
That's the United States done.
I'm going to die.
I'll take 6 points if you get eight
with four. That's that one. Don't do that one. That helps us, not you.
And do you move the turn marker on?
I did.
Yep, awesome. Okay, so we are back to Germany.
My man. Oh dear. What does Germany?
You haven't got build navy, have you? By any chance?
No.
Oh, if you had build navy, that would be hilarious.
It would be good.
Build a navy in the North Sea.
It would be so nice if I had that right now. I will use.
It's not worth doing a land battle, they're dead after this turn.
You might be lying.
They're dead after this turn.
So we thought it was D-Day, but actually it was a bit more Dunkirk.
I think I don't really know what to be fair at this point. Because all these uses, I'm going to have to discard cards.
Nothing
is useful.
I could discard some cards from my pile, but actually no, I won't discard some cards. I'm going to get the Soviet one because there's no point.
I will keep these because you're going to come back. Yeah, that's what you draw up.
And I will draw up.
United Kingdom.
I feel like there's no.
Oh, I needed two more cards.
It's not going well for the Allies.
The Allies are having a terrible time.
So, no.
Okay, so you've done. So
yeah,
you get two points for the Allies. Did you score for Germany, by the
way? Oh, okay.
So, oh, now we did say.
Yeah, no, you
we did say we have gone past the turn.
So I've lost 6 points for our team.
Okay, Japan. I actually have no idea what I'm going to do.
Everything you like.
I guess I build an. Oh, I can't build an army. Could you have a look? No, that's no good.
I get 7 points.
That's no good.
Pay one.
You can't
take comes out. No, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I'm not happy about it.
I'm going to lay this status. Doesn't help me at the moment, but I get plus one victory point if I'm occupying Iwo Jima or Philippines, which I'm not, so it doesn't help me. So I'm going to gain. I don't have a gold army, so I'm going to gain 5 victory points. Yep. And then I'm going to draw a card.
Who
are
they?
I don't care what one's left.
Right.
Everything's changing.
Who do I get to play as?
Okay. And it is. Yep.
The US or the UK?
It is Soviet Union.
Oh, good. I think it's fair to say that these are
Oh, yeah, because you should have done that on your turn.
Yeah.
Shall I build an army? Build an army or build an army? Yeah. Shall I make sure that the Soviet army in Ukraine has remained in the moon?
Goal has no options for the Soviet Union. If you're watching our channel from Russia, I apologise for the half of the goal.
I'm going to have to discard a further 3 cards and then pick another 3 up.
If you're from the United Kingdom. I have to apologise.
We could have a land battle or build an army.
Yes.
I've got 10.
I'm pretty sure Winston Churchill is like spinning in his grave right now.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
And I'm done.
Okay, that was the Soviet Union. Italy. The rather more successful Italians.
Let's hope that
pays off. Oh, very successful.
Mainly because I know where
to get it. Straight away. Okay, all right. You're scoring for Russia. Just score for Italy.
4 points for Italy.
Now, we were quickly checking. 94. So we would need to be 124. We're not far off it, so if you're careful, we are actually getting near to be 30 points ahead.
Thank God.
Put these allies out of their misery. That was. I've forgotten where we are now, so that was Italy, so United States.
America!
Let's take a look.
Is still driving around the Pacific.
You should have a battle.
I'd love to have a battle, but there's nothing I can touch. Plenty of sea battles, I think.
Yeah.
Just nowhere I can talk.
Yeah.
Subverse, but he's not actually going to gain anything.
What, is he a friend in Japan?
I don't think he's going to achieve anything, but at least it's going to make the US feel useful. Let's be having that.
Oh, what did you do? That's rude.
Sea battle to your sea in Japan.
Damn it. That's not nice. I'll change what I do now.
I still think you have plenty of options available.
Actually, no, I won't. I'll do what I was going to do.
The US. Well, I guess another 6 points.
6 points. The US is actually doing its way, finally.
Turn Michael was on. Germany.
Germany is going to build a navy.
What? In the North Sea! Invasion imminent, I think.
We are surrounded.
We will fight them
on the beaches.
You need a big cigar.
I'm like a big cigar, right?
I feel like I should put like an army here as well, just so I can like make it really historic.
It's got a lot. Mine might be a bit too late for that now.
That's right.
We could do that. Like, we've got the time. You know, just carry on. Right, score for Germany.
Germany 6 points.
6 points. We are now 4 points away from
total domination of the goal.
Let's just play as the Soviet Union.
United Kingdom.
Disappointed.
So keen to do nothing for the turn. And please say you have sea battles.
Sea battles?
I do, but let me just... Let me see if there's anything else. I've got two sea battles, haven't I? Let's have it. And we'll lock this guy out.
You killed my... Oh, I was getting excited there. I was a little bit excited.
Unfortunately.
And I'm going to take...
Ooh, and then it is Japan. We need to get to 32, don't we? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I need to score 6 points.
I think it's 10.
Can I score 6 points? Oh! So I'm going to score 5, right? The United States must discard the top card of its draw deck, gain 2 victory points. And then score 2, 4, 5 to put us on 33. That is 30 points ahead, officially. Winners of World War II are the Axis of evil.
That's right.
But the United Kingdom retains its independence. It retained its independence.
Let's try and push.
Well, that's a fun game.
Commiserations. Commiserations.
Good game, go.
The second that Moscow went down, it was
Yeah, it was all over, wasn't it? It was all over.
Russia fell. Gold fell. Bane and Glenn won.
So take that as a warning, ladies and gentlemen. If Russia falls, we all fall.
Oh dear.
Is that what we learned?
That's what we've learned.
Yeah, that's the takeaway. That is the takeaway from today.
I'd like to take time to thank Mug and Meeple and Glenn in particular for hosting our video today on YouTube. As always, if you've liked this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. And remember, you can also follow us on Patreon. Links to the Mug and Meeple will be in the description. And obviously, do check out our other videos. There's much more to come in. Up and coming.
Up and coming. Talking,
how's it for Budweiser? Drunkenness.
Cup and umming.
Very soon on GB Gaming. But anyway, from Bane, the Mug and Meeple, go! And everybody in the show!